Very good morning to one and all present in the virtual class for today's session, that is 16th of July 2021, with the further explanation for chapter The Mughal Empire. हम लोगों ने आज अपने मुगल अंपायर के चैप्टर में आगे एक्सटेंशन करना है. वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट द मनसबदार्स एंड जागीरदार्स. हमने मनसबदार्स कल मैंने आपको इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया था मनसबदार्स के लिए कि मनसबदार्स मींस द पर्संस द इंडिविजुअल्स हु विल बी होल्डिंग द हाई पोजीशंस एंड रैंक इन द मुगल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन स्ट्रक्चर. So these were Mansabdars were from the diverse background. These Mansabdars were from the different countries. Like कौन-कौन सी countries थे? मैंने पांच areas बताए थे आपको. One was कौन-कौन थे? Please Hargun, if you can, please बताइए. That was Iranis, Afghanis,
Indian Muslims.
Please try not to speak because your voice is cracking and it create sound problem here. So Mansabdars were from the diverse background from the different countries like Turanis, Afghanis, Iranis, Indian Muslims and Rajputs, Marathas. So इस तरह से वो सब diverse background से मुगल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के अंदर एज अ मनसबदार अपॉइंट कर. मनसबदार्स रेफर टू द इंडिविजुअल्स हु इज होल्डिंग अ मनसब. इंडिविजुअल इज होल्डिंग अ मनसब. मनसब मींस रैंक और पोजीशन. ठीक है, रैंक और पोजीशन. सो इस तरह से मनसबदार्स जो थे देवर making the responsibility of number one. क्या क्या responsibilities करते थे? Look at the page number 51. Second paragraph for the Mansabdars and Jagirdars में the term Mansabdar refers to individuals who hold Mansab, meaning position or rank, was the grading system by the Mughals to fix. ये एक grading system होता था. Mansab के first rank है, second rank है, के third rank. ठीक है, इस रैंक पर जो है मनसबदार्स अपॉइंट है एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट उनका रैंक सैलरी और मिलिट्री रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज उनको दी जाती है. अकॉर्डिंग टू द रैंक दे गेट देयर सैलरीज, दे गेट देयर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. एंड दे गेट द पहली चीज उनको सैलरी, दूसरी चीज उनका रैंक और तीसरी चीज उनकी मिलिट्री रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. रैंक और सैलरीज दैट वर डिटरमाइंड बाय द न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू. अब जो ये रैंक होता था, ये रैंक अब मैंने फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड लिख दिया, दैट वाज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल. यू कैन से न्यूमेरिकल फॉर्म में, न्यूमेरिकल फॉर्म में, दैट इज कॉल्ड जैट. अब ये जैट वर्ड याद रहेगा, जैट वर्ड याद रहेगा.
यस मैम.
यस मैम. So, पहले मनसबदार्स, those who were getting the मनसब rank, according to the rank, they get their salary, their responsibility to hold and their military responsibilities. और ये जो मनसब थे उनको numerical data में rank दिया जाता था, that is called ZAT. यानी कि numerical form में first, second, third, जैसे मैंने अभी Roman letters में लिखा है, वैसे उनको जो है वो ZAT कहा जाता है, कि what is your ZAT? So the higher the ZAT, जिसका higher होगा ZAT, उसका उतना ही ज्यादा जो है prestigious होगा, उतना ही ज्यादा वो जो है अपना position holder होगा, उतनी ज्यादा उसकी salary होगी और उतनी ज्यादा उसके ऊपर military responsibilities ज्यादा. Higher the ZAT, higher the salary, higher the responsibilities. Any doubt? है कोई डाउट? सो नेक्स्ट पोजीशन इन द कोड एंड लार्जर इन सेल्फ. थर्ड पैराग्राफ इफ इट इज क्लियर. सेकंड पैराग्राफ इज क्लियर प्लीज गिव थम्स अप सो दैट आई कैन प्रोसीड.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
हाँ जी बोलो बेटा.
हम आज भी न्यूमेरिक वैल्यू को हम जेड कहते हैं.
वंशिका यू आर नॉट एट ऑल ऑर्डरेजेस
मैम.
हाँ वंशिका बोलो.
मैम मैं कह रही हूँ कि आज भी हम न्यूमेरिकल नंबर्स को जेड कहते हैं.
नहीं उनके टाइम पे कहते हैं. हाँ जी. नाउ थर्ड पैराग्राफ that is once of course military's responsibilities required him to maintain specific numbers of sawar. ab jo ye inko military responsibilities milti thi wo kitne unhone karne ka they have to count kyunki unhone unko salaries deni hai unhone unko maintain karna hai to wo kitne number mein unke paas they had the specified number of sawars or cavalry. cavalry man hote hain ghod sawar. सवार तभी लिख दिया गया घोड़े को लेकर जो मिलिट्री मेंटेन करते हैं घोड़ों से जो मिलिट्री मेंटेन करते हैं दैट वाज कंसीडर्ड टू बी एज अ सवार. सो मनसबदार ब्रॉट द कैवेलरी मैन फॉर रिव्यू गॉट देम रजिस्टर्ड उनको रजिस्टर्ड करते थे एंड देयर हॉर्स ब्रांडेड एंड दे रिसीव मनी टू पे देम एज अ सेल. मनसबदार दे स्पेसिफाई द नंबर्स ऑफ सवार और कैवेलरी. They review or registered the cavalryman. उनको review भी करते थे उनको registered भी करते थे और उनकी properly checking भी करते थे कि whether the सवार और cavalryman is able to maintain the military control whenever the services are being required. मनसबदार का ये काम होता था कि अपने area के अंदर ने एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कंट्रोल अपने एरिया के अंदर उन्होंने यू कैन से दिस मिलिट्री कंट्रोल जो है वो पूरा मेंटेन करो. सो मनसबदार का काम किया है यहाँ तक. थर्ड पैराग्राफ मनसबदार रिसीव देयर सैलरी. अब इनको पैसा देना दैट पेमेंट इज गिवन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैश. पेमेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैश. कैश की फॉर्म में देना. अब ये कैश आएगा कहां से? ये कैश आएगा कहां से? दैट विल बी कम फ्रॉम द रेवेन्यू. रेवेन्यू क्या मतलब? जो टैक्स जितना एरिया अलॉट किया होता था मनसबदार जितना एरिया अलॉट किया होता था वहां से उस अलॉटेड एरिया से उन्होंने क्या लेना होता था? रेवेन्यू कलेक्ट करना होता था फ्रॉम द फार्मर्स. So they have to collect the revenue from the farmers, from the potters, from the you can say masons or the persons who were working within the territory controlled by Mansabdar. They collect the revenue from them and then that revenue is being distributed in the form of salaries to the military persons. As military persons, cavalry men are also being, you can say, checked, you can say, registered, properly maintained by the Mansabdar. Higher the Mansabdar, higher the rank, higher the responsibility. And these ranks are in the form of numerical that are called ZAT. Is it clear? So,
yes, ma'am.
Last point, last paragraph from page number 51. मनसबदार रिसीव देयर सैलरी एज अ रेवेन्यू असाइनमेंट कॉल्ड जागीर. अब यहाँ पर आके जागीर ये वाला वर्ड अभी तक हमने यूज नहीं किया. सो जो रेवेन्यू दे रिसीव दैट इज कॉल्ड जागीर. ठीक है. द रेवेन्यू विच दे रिसीव फ्रॉम देयर एरिया टेरिटरी एरिया दैट इज कॉल्ड जागीर विच इज समवट लाइक. इसको क्या कहा जाता था? इक्कास. अब इसका अनदर नेम है बिकॉज हम उस लैंग्वेज के फॉर्म में कर रहे हैं. दीज जागीर्स आर कॉल्ड इक्कास. दीज आर कॉल्ड इक्कास. प्लीज अंडरलाइन बिकॉज ये 1-1 मार्क के क्वेश्चंस हैं. डैश जागीर इज आल्सो कॉल्ड डैश. मनसबदार रिसीव देयर सैलरी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डैश. ठीक है. which is what was, and unlike Muktis, most Mansabdar did not actually reside in the administration as their jagirs. अब जो बहुत सारे मनसबदार जो थे दे वर नॉट लिविंग इन दैट एरिया विच इज बीइंग अलॉटेड टू देम, दे आर लिविंग फार एरिया. जरूरी तो नहीं कि जिस एरिया में एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कंट्रोल मिला हो वहीं पर ही मनसबदार रहता हो, बिकॉज मनसबदार वर, हमने सबसे पहले पैराग्राफ में यही देखा था कि मनसबदार वर फ्रॉम द डाइवर्स बैकग्राउंड, दे वर फ्रॉम द डिफरेंट कंट्रीज as Turanis, Iranis, Indian Muslims and Afghanis or Rajputs and Marathas, ye sare the. To zaruri to nahi hai ki wo unko jo mansab mila ho, unko jo area mila ho, wo wahi par hi rahe, zaruri to nahi, but they are supposed to collect the revenue jagir from that area. Ek taas, so most mansabdar did not actually reside or administer their jagir, they only had right to collect the revenue from the assignments which was collected for them by the servants. वहां पर रहने वाले servants उनके लिए collect करके रखते थे and which they gave to them as mansabdar themselves served in some other part of the country. Is it okay to everyone? यहां तक किसी को कोई doubt है तो please tell. Any doubt to anyone? This was all about the mansabdars, jagirdars, and their profiles, what they are doing. Then now we have to study about the work of Akbar. Akbar ne apna, humne kaha tha na humne Akbar ko achhi tarah se detail mein study karna hai. Now we have to go with the Akbar. Akbar kaisa tha? Akbar's regents, jagirs were carefully assessed. Akbar ke time par, now this is 5-mark question. How the administration or mansabdars were effectively working during the Akbar's reign of time, Akbar region of time. कैसा करते थे? So upper region these jagirs were carefully assessed. Carefully मतलब बड़े ध्यान से, assessed means देखा जाना, like cavalry वगैरह, मंसबदार्स, ये सारा कुछ बड़े ध्यान से देखा जाना. So they were, the revenue were roughly equal to the salary of मंसबदार. The revenue which was being collected by the Mansabdar was equal to the rank, but Aurangzeb's reason was no longer the case of actual revenue collected was often less than the granted sum. Means Akbar's administration was very effective. He know ki kitna unka salary ka budget hai, to utna Mansabdars ko collect ho jata tha zyat. जागीर्स और इक्तास, मतलब सैलरी उतनी कलेक्ट, रेवेन्यू की फॉर्म में उतना कलेक्ट हो जाता था अकबर के टाइम पर. लेकिन अगर हम औरंगजेब की बात करें तो औरंगजेब के टाइम पर मनसबदार्स के ऊपर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ज्यादा थी. मनसबदार्स के ऊपर दे हैव टू पे मोर सैलरीज टू द मिलिट्री कंट्रोल, बट द रेवेन्यू विच दे वर गेटिंग लाइक जागीर्स दे वर कलेक्टिंग एंड इक्तास दे वर कलेक्टिंग वॉज लेस देन दैट. So Mansabdars were not at all beneficial during the time of Aurangzeb, but Mansabdars were equally getting all the benefits during the time of Akbar. Can we say Akbar's administration policy was more effective as compared to Aurangzeb policy? This was another one reason why the deterioration of Mughals was done after the Aurangzeb. Pata chala? Samajh aaya ki nahi aaya Ramni? Arjo? Okay. So there was also a huge increase in the number. Ab dusri karan kya tha? During the Akbar region of time, Akbar administration time, the mansabdars were less in number, but jo mansabdars ko diya hua tha na rank diya hua tha, these mansabdars were very less. Lekin Aurangzeb ne apne time mein mansabdars bahut increase kar di. तो मनसबदार इंक्रीज कर दिया तो दे हैव टू गिव सैलरीज टू देम, दे हैव टू गिव जागीर्स टू देम, सो दैट द रेवेन्यू कैन बी कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम दैट दैट साइड. सो दिस वाज अनदर वन रीजन व्हाई मुगल्स वर बीइंग डिटीरियोरेटेड आफ्टर दिस टाइम. सो नेक्स्ट आ जाता है, दीज वर द अदर फैक्टर क्रिएटेड शॉर्टेज ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ जागीर. एज अ रिजल्ट जागीरदार ट्राई टू एक्सट्रैक्ट एज मच एज रेवेन्यू एज पॉसिबल व्हाइल दे हैड अ जागीर. अब क्या हुआ, अकबर्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन मनसबदार्स वर गेटिंग इक्वल रेवेन्यू एज मच एज दे हैव टू पे द सैलरीज टू द मिलिट्री रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, ठीक है, मिलिट्री पर्सन्स. बट औरंगजेब टाइम Mansabdars were more. They were not at all getting equal jagirs, as they were in high in numbers. Their number strength is more. The jagir was given to other person, matlab jagirdars, those who were supposed to collect the revenue from for them. तो वो क्या करते थे? They were corrupt. वो देते ही नहीं थे आगे मनसबदार्स को. That was the another reason of declining aurangzeb. मतलब आगे जागीरदार जो थे, जो लोकल एरिया पर्सन थे, क्योंकि मनसबदार्स वर नॉट लिविंग इन दैट लोकल एरिया. तो जो जागीरदार थे, those who were collecting the revenue, they were not giving that same revenue to the मनसबदार्स. Is the point is clear? Any doubt to anyone? Harguan, Jaiveer, is it okay? So Aurangzeb was unable to control these developments in the last years of his region, and the peasantry therefore suffered tremendously. Peasantry jo hai, that was being suffered, and they were being in loss. That is why Britishers were able to curb the condition of the Mughals' territory and put their administrative control on a. Any doubt to anyone up to this? If it is clear, please give thumbs up, so that next I should proceed Zabt and Zamindars.
Ma'am, please repeat this again.
Once again, if you have doubt, Akbar ke region mein jagirdar was, jagirs were carefully assessed hota tha, and the payment or revenue which was being received by the mansabdar was equal to the salary they have to pay to the military officers or military persons, as it was a totally balanced, because Akbar administration was considered to be as a effective administration. On the other side, Aurangzeb's administration during that period of time, number of mansabdars were also increased, and the revenue which was being collected during that time was not equal to the amount of the salary which they have to pay to the military persons. Another side, jagirdars during the time of Aurangzeb, they were becoming, you can say, corrupt. They were not giving the whole collection which they were collecting from the local area as a form of revenue to the mansabdars. Another, this region was also led a cause for the deterioration of the you can say Aurangzeb, and it that led to the you can say fall of Mughals during after the time of Aurangzeb. Is it okay? No doubt.
मैम, जागीरदार का मीनिंग एक बार समझा.
जागीरदार कौन होते थे? लोकल पर्सन्स, दोज हु वर कलेक्टिंग द रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम द लोकल पेजेंट्स, फार्मर्स, लोकल यू कैन से आर्टिशियन वर्कर्स, लोकल यू कैन से पॉटर्स, जो भी लोकल काम करते थे उनसे वो टैक्सेस और रेवेन्यू रिसीव करते थे. And that revenue they have to give it to the mansabdar, and mansabdar they pay the cash salaries to the military persons, so that military effectiveness in that area should be maintained. But Aurangzeb ke time par aisa kuch bhi nahi ho pa raha. Any doubts to anyone? Yahan tak clear hai?
Jagirdars were the servants that were appointed by the mansabdars.
Yes, jagirdars, those who were maintaining and controlling the local control over the jagirs, which were being assigned to the mansabdars. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now come to the next concept, that is zabt and zamindars. Ab zabt kaun hai and zamindar kaun hai? The main source of income available in the Mughal emperor was dash. That was tax. That was revenue. The main source of income for the Mughal was tax, or we can say on the production of the peasantry. Sara, maine abhi bataya ki they were collecting the taxes from the, you can say, peasants, from the artisan worker, from the cobbler, from the, you can say, handicraft worker. And the most places, peasants paid taxes through the rural elite. Rural ameer logo ko, gaon ke ameer logo ko, they were paying the taxes. Jaise gaon ka ek headman hota hai, they were paying the taxes to the headman of the local village. So that is the headman or the local chieftain. उसको headman और local chieftain बोला जाता था. The Mughals used this term on one term that zamindar to describe all intermediary. अब zamindar कौन है? All the intermediaries, those who were collecting the taxes from the common people at the local area and have maintaining the responsibility to hand over that revenue directly to the municipalities. To describe all intermediaries, there were the local headmen of the village or powerful chief. Is it okay to everyone? First paragraph from Zabt and Zamindar is clear. Then second paragraph, that is Akbar's. अब आ जाइए अकबर के टाइम पर. This was the common paragraph for everyone. Now we have to give emphasis only on the Akbar. Akbar's revenue minister, Todarmal. Now 1.1 mark question. Who was the revenue minister during the time of Akbar? Write down this question on the left hand side of your book on this same page. Who was the revenue minister of Akbar? Or Dash was the revenue minister of Akbar. Carried out carefully survey of the crop field price yield and price and cultivated for 10-year period of time. अब देखिए अकबर का administration totally different था. किस तरह से अकबर का जो revenue minister था, he has not imposed the same tax on every quality of land. Some farmer, some person may have the good quality of a land with full of fertility. Some farmer may not have good quality of land, so the same tax cannot be paid by the two person. So Todarmal, as the finance minister, what he do? He make the careful assessment of all the individual land or survey the land individually. Usne survey kiya for 10 years. 10 years har saal karte the wo survey, and according to the productivity, according to the fertility, the tax was being imposed on the land. Isn't it different? Kya aaj ki hamari sarkar aisa karti hai? Unhone to GST laga diya, kaam khatam. Every person has to pay, whether they are able or capable or not capable. So we can say how the Akbar's administration policy, how the revenue minister Akbar's Todarmal was so effective that usne pehle pura survey kiya. He had made the survey for 10 years and then he had put the taxes according to the fertility of the land. As if a land is fertile, then more tax. If a land is less fertile, then less tax. Is the point is clear? So the crop yield, price, area cultivated for 10 years from 1570 to 1580. On the basis of that data, tax was fixed on each crop. So each provinces was divided into revenue circle. हर provinces को, हर area को revenue circle में बांट दिया गया कि यहाँ से high revenue आएगा, यहाँ से कम आएगा, यहाँ से बिल्कुल नहीं आएगा, यहाँ से और कम आएगा, like that. So different. Each provinces was divided into different circle and own schedule of revenue rates for the individual crops. So the revenue system, this type of revenue system was known as Zabt. Is it okay? This type of revenue system, like according to the fertility, according to the capability, as the long survey was being made by the Todarmal from 1570 to 1580, then the finances, the taxes were being imposed on the different circle of the provinces, and that was known as a Zabt. So this was prevalent in those area where Mughal administration could survey the land and keep the record of every and carefully account. Or is tarah se Akbar's administration was very effective. Akbar's mansabdars, they were maintaining, jo unke zamindars the, they were maintaining the record properly, and this was not possible in the provinces such as Gujarat and Bengal. So this is another one mark question, that in which states the administrative Zabt administration was not at all possible. that was this was not possible in the provinces such as Gujarat and Bengal. Is it okay up to this? So in some areas, zamindars exercise a great deal of power. Exploitation by the Mughal administrators could drive them rebellion. Some zamindars and peasants of some caste allies in the rebellion against Mughal authority. Kuch areas mein rebellion bhi hue Mughals ke against where they were collecting the high taxes. So these peasants report challenged the stability of the Mughal empire from the end of the 17th century. End of the 17th century mein kuch Mughal tribes, ab main yahan par naam lena chahungi, Ohms ka. They had given the reward not to provide control over their area, kyunki wo area jo hai, Ohms ka jo area hai, wo Assam ka area hai, Assam area ka, Assam part, Bharat ka Assam area jo hai, wo area tha, and that was very fertile area. So inhone taxes zyada laga diye. So they were not ready to pay that high taxes too. So some areas were getting the revolt against the Mughals. So it was not at all easy for the Mughals to maintain this kind of zapt, you can say, administration over that area. Is it okay after this? Any doubt to anyone? And next topic, a closer look, Akbar's policy, that I will explain in the next tomorrow's class. Fine.